Iliotibial band syndrome, or IT band syndrome, is another common cause of knee pain. This usually occurs with pain on the lateral or outboard aspect of the knee and can be extremely painful. Make sure to get your knee evaluated before you start this progression, but these are some good exercises to help alleviate your IT band syndrome. If your hamstrings are tight, your knees are probably going to be in pain, regardless of what the rest of your knee problems are. So before we start addressing anything else, we have to get your hamstrings loosened up. Easy way to do it, take a bench, a table, whatever you have access to, place your foot up on it, reach down, touch the toe, or as far down as you can go for 15 to 30 seconds. And you'll do that 3 times. As you get more flexible, you'll grab the foot further, sit back a little more, you can always bend down and touch your toes, whatever you're able to do. Once again, 3 sets, 15 to 30 seconds. When you're having knee pain, you also want to make sure that your quads, hip flexors, everything like that is nice and loose. This is also true in the case of hip flexor strains. So to achieve that, we have kind of a double duty stretch here to stretch both the quads and your hip flexors. You'll take a bench, chair, bed, whatever you want to put your foot on. You can do it on the couch, place it up here, knee on the ground. Now you want to have something soft underneath your knee. We don't need to create more knee pain from you kneeling on something hard. Set up in kind of a lunge position, sit back to create that tension in the quadricep, and then lean forward while you're arching back so that you get a nice pull on that hip flexor. Once again, sit back to create the tension in the quadricep and lean forward, placing the tension on the hip flexor. You'll do that for 3 sets of 15 to 30 seconds on each side. Okay. Although it's difficult to actually stretch the IT band itself, it's important to stretch the muscles in that area if you're trying to improve your pain from IT band syndrome. A good way to achieve that is to put your hand on something stable, whether it's a wall, a rack, whatever you have. Put your foot down, cross the other one over, and then lean out. You're gonna hold this for 15 to 30 seconds, really feeling that stretch all through here. Now, like I said, this will not stretch your actual IT band itself. It's a very hard piece of fibrous tissue, but this will help stretch the muscles of that area. So once again, holding on here and kick that hip out until you feel a stretch. 3 sets, 15 to 30 seconds. With knee pain, whether it be from IT band syndrome, patellofemoral pain syndrome, or any other cause, the quads can sometimes be weak, especially in the case of the medial or inboard quad, known as the VMO. That's this muscle right here. So the way we strengthen that is a leg extension. You'll start out with an isometric leg extension. So you have this band wrapped around the leg, and that's going to provide tension. For isometric, you'll start with tension, bring it out, hold for 10 seconds. You can always grab onto something if you need balance. Keeping that nice strong flex in the quadricep. And once you've held for 10 count, you bring it back. You should be doing 5 sets of those. Once you feel strong with the isometric movement, you can start to do it dynamically. Forward, back. Forward, back. Forward, back. Now, this is obviously more effective with the leg extension machine, but not all of us have access to that at home. If you want to go to the gym and do these, that's perfectly fine. And will probably be more useful. But just make sure, since we're trying to strengthen this inner quad, that you keep your foot turned out while you're doing the extensions. Toes should be out, and really squeeze this muscle in here. Strengthening the muscles of abduction of the hip, or moving the leg outwards, is also important in the treatment of IT band syndrome. This is a side-lying leg raise. As you can see, she's lying on her side with her head on a block to protect her neck from flexing the wrong way, with her arm in a position that's comfortable. Wherever you want to put your arm when you're lying like this is fine with me. Anything that's comfortable for you. So you're going to take the leg, raise it up, hold it for 5 seconds, and then let it come back down, nice and controlled. Once again, up, hold, and then back down, nice and controlled. You should be feeling it in the muscles right on the outside of your hip, and that will help you strengthen those muscles to reduce your IT band pain. Another important progression in knee rehabilitation is strengthening of what's called terminal or end range knee extension, and becoming stable in that motion. One good way to achieve that is the step up. Now, you don't have to have a fancy block like this one. Anything you have at home to step up on, a curb or a step, for example, your staircase, perfectly works. So the way you'll achieve this, placing one foot on the block, you can always grab onto something if you need help for balance, push up on that foot, hold for a second, get stable, and come back down. Once again, push up on that foot, stable, come back down. Make sure you're not driving off this bottom leg because that defeats the purpose of strengthening this one. You'll do 3 sets of 10 on each side. A good progression to work on your stabilization from the regular step up is the band resistance step up. So this is going to be pulling your knee outwards, away from your body, or laterally, so that you can strengthen the muscles inside the leg, just like that VMO that we talked about on the other exercise. So you'll do the same thing as a regular step up. Driving off this foot, come up, stabilize, come back down. Once again, come up, stabilize, come back down. That'll also be for 3 sets of 10 in place of the regular step ups. It's always okay to use something to balance on if you need to. That way you don't fall down and hurt yourself.